So I'm gonna do two pieces. So the first one is actually, it's kind of weird, but I honor my ex's like sobriety dates, only because like he's a special son of a person. But he was actually the first person I ever met with an addiction, and the way I grew up was like, you know, Gossip Girl or, you know, these reality shows, and it was all very pretty, and, you know, all the cool kids did drugs, and I never really saw the dark side of it. But what I knew about addicts was what I saw, like, my family teach me, and, you know, they were weak, and they were selfish, and horrible people, and he really opened my eyes, and so he was actually my inspiration of what I'm going to school for. I'm going for chemical counseling. And so this is, I actually wrote almost 9 years ago. Wow. So it's called Letter to an Addict. Dear friend, first off, I want to tell you how wonderful you are, that you are special and unique. So don't mind language, I'm like 20 years old. First off, I want to tell you how wonderful you are, that you are special and unique, that you play an irreplaceable role in my life. Dear friend, I want to tell you how much that I've enjoyed getting to know you, how in awe of you I am in your journey. I've never met anyone with such grace and kindness. Dear friend, I want to tell you how sometimes I don't know which one of you I'm going to work I am with, that sometimes I lay awake wondering if this is the night I will wake up and you will be gone. Dear friend, dear friend. Dear friend, I can't watch you die anymore. So that was my lovely little piece. So I'm not very happy writing tonight. So this other piece I actually wrote the other day. Sorry, I had to find it first. So it doesn't have a name, but this year, I've, ever since Charlottesville, and just with everything that's going on, like, I've never been so aware and uncomfortable with my skin, but then also, like, very proud of my skin, and it's pushed me to learn about my culture, learn about my history, something as simple as I hate my hair, and so, like, it's been, like, an act of protest, and an act of rebellion, and an act of self-care and self-love, like to wear my natural hair. Today I'm not wearing it because it just didn't want to work. But finding different ways of doing it. So this doesn't have a title, but last night I had a terrible dream. I was home and everything was different but the same. The trees were still covered in Spanish moss. I could still stand on 12th Ave and know my way home like the back of my hand. I smelled that hot, heavy, sweet smell of home. Home like you only find in the South. Hot, sultry, fries my natural hair in under 2 seconds flat. I greeted long-lost friends and cried as my godmother held my face, telling me, baby girl, your dad would be so proud of you. And that used to be my nightmare, waking up and realizing it was all just a dream. Home was never safety. It all seems so picture perfect. Betty White standing in her front yard, that for a fact I know that she's not the right Betty. My Betty was soft-voiced, graceful, and all-Southern. But she smiles at me and makes a mean lemonade as I reacquaint myself with the neighborhood. I pass that street, bracing myself for you to pop out, but no, a sigh of relief, it's just a street again. Everything is quiet, serene, perfect. But then it turned dark, and I was fighting with my mother. She left the front doors to my childhood home wide open, and I heard them singing. Saw their shadows in the flame and their torches that lit the night sky. I heard their voices and it chilled me to the bone. I saw fear on the faces of those I loved as I skirted windows, creeping like a thief in my own home to lock the doors to keep them out. I just needed to keep them out. And then I wake up, reoriented myself, slow my racing heart, and it's over, or that's how it usually goes. I find comfort knowing it was just a nightmare. But as I settle, a deep, rolling fear permeates because for once, I can't say it's maybe it makes me naive. Are an ostrich in the sand, and it took a couple thousand angry white men marching on a college campus to wake me up. But it's not just a nightmare anymore. And I found myself sitting in my tub crying. And I wondered how many girls just like me are waking up with their singing still ringing in their ears. How many are trying to make sense of a home that no longer feels safe anymore? How many felt that deep bone fear when faces of the people they knew and loved were on the 9 o'clock news or the cover of every major outlet, news outlet? How do they ever sleep?